Hello everyone, this is Anu Agrawal here. So now I'm going to tell you about least square approximation, which comes under inner product space. So let's talk about the application of least square approximations. It often happens that Ax is equal to b has no solution. Thus the usualization is too many equations. The matrix has more rows than the columns. So there are more equations than unknowns, or we can say that m is greater than n. So the n columns span a small part of m dimensional space. Unless all the measurements are perfect, b is outside that column space. When ax is equal to b has no solution, then we multiply by a raised to power t, that is, we can say that the transpose of the matrix A, and solve a raised to power t into a into x cap, which is equal to at into b. The method of least square is a standard approach in regression analysis to approximate the solution of overdetermined system, that is, set of equations in which there are more equations than unknowns. Least squares means that the overall solution minimizes the sum of the squares of residuals made in the result of every single equation. Let's talk about some theorems and examples. The first is, let A be an m cross n matrix and V be a vector in R raised to power m. Then a vector x cap in Rn is a solution to the normal equation At into Ax is equal to At into B. If and only if it is a least square solution to Ax is equal to b. Now the proof is, we know that a least square solution x cap to Ax is equal to b exists. Then by the theorem stated as, if W is a finite dimensional subspace of an inner product space V, then V is equal to W plus W bar. So apply this theorem, we get there are unit vectors w1 in w is equal to column of a and w2 in w bar, such that b is equal to w1 plus w2. First assume that x cap is a least square solution. Since w2 is orthogonal to column of a, then at w2 is equal to 0. Moreover, since x cap is a least square solution, then a into x cap is equal to w1. Therefore, at into ax bar x cap is equal to at w1, which is equal to at into b minus w2, which is equal to at into b. So that x cap is a solution to the normal equation. Conversely, we now show that if x cap is a solution to at into ax is equal to at into b, then it is also a least square solution to Ax is equal to b. Suppose that At into Ax cap is equal to At into b, or equivalently At into b minus A into x cap is equal to 0. Then consequently the vector b minus A into x cap is orthogonal to each row of At and hence to each column of A. Since the column of A spans W, the vector b minus a into x cap is in w bar, hence b can be written as b is equal to a into x cap plus b minus a into x cap, where a into x cap is in w is equal to column a and b is minus a into x cap is in w bar. Again, by the theorem stated as, if w is a finite dimensional subspace of an inner product space V, then V is equal to W plus W bar. Then by using this theorem, this decomposition of the vector B is unique, and hence A into X cap is equal to W1. Therefore, X bar is a least square solution. So now let's take the example. First is, let A is equal to the matrix containing minus 2, 3, 1, minus 2, 1, minus 1. And B is equal to the matrix 1, minus 1, 2. Then first find the least square solution to Ax is equal to B. Now come to the solution. Since the linear system Ax is equal to B is inconsistent, then the least square solution is the best approximation we can find. Now, by the previous theorem, the least square solution can be found by solving the normal equation at into ax is equal to at into b. In this case, the normal equation becomes the matrix minus 2, 1, 1, 3, minus 2, minus 1 into the matrix, which is a transformation of previous matrix, and into the matrix containing x, y is equal to the transpose of the matrix A into B, which simplifies to the 2 cross 2 matrix 6 minus 9 minus 9 14 into the matrix XY is equal to the matrix minus 1 3. The matrix on the left hand side is invertible so that the XY is equal to 1 by 3 into the matrix 14 9 9 6 into the matrix minus 1 and 3. Thus, the least square solution is then given by x cap is equal to the matrix xy is equal to the matrix 13 by 3 and 3. Now, the second part is find the orthogonal projection of B onto W is equal to column of A and the decomposition B is equal to W1 plus W2, where W1 is in W and W2 is in W bar. So, the solution is to find the orthogonal projection W1 of B onto W is equal to column A, we use the fact that W1 is equal to A into X cap. So, W1 is equal to the matrix A into the matrix X cap, which is equal to 1 by 3 into the matrix 1 minus 5, 4. We now find W2 from the equation W2 is equal to B minus W1. So that W2 is equal to B minus W1, which is equal to 2 minus 2 by 3 into the matrix 1, 1, 1. Now, the decomposition of B is then given by B is equal to W1 plus W2, which is equal to 1 by 3 into 1 minus 5, 4 plus 2 by 3 into the matrix 1, 1 and 1. Thank you, everyone.